was having so much fun, he did not notice that he dropped a mitten. Soon a mole came along. When he saw the mitten, he hurried inside. It was so warm and very cozy. "I will stay," he said.
Next day, Rabbit talked by. She saw the mole inside the mitten. "I think you need a friend to keep you company," said the rabbit as she wiggled in. The mole did not argue. When a hedgehog peeked into the mitten, the rabbit and mole decided to friend for Emma. "But my prickles will keep enemies away," said the hedgehog as she sneezed in.
Along came a badger who was looking for a place to rest. "My soft fur will make a nice bed for you," he said. Then he pushed and wiggled inside the mitten.
That animal gave a sigh and settled down once more until they heard a bark. "I can protect you," he said. "My sharp teeth will do the job." Then he made himself thin enough to squeeze in.
The animals wiggled and waggled. They tossed and they turned, trying to get comfortable.
"What's going on in there?" cried the big brown bear. "You need someone to clean pigs. I'm just the one to do it. Settle down, where I call it."
Please. The men bulged and stretched as the bear took its place. Everyone held still, afraid to move. Then along came a tiny, tiny mouse.
She looked at the huge mitten full of frightened faces. "Whatever is the mitten? Tell me what has scared you so."
But the animals were afraid to speak. They thought the mitten might burst. They sat so still they seemed frozen.
The mouse looked around for signs of danger, but saw nothing. "Why, it must be me," she decided. "You're afraid of a tiny mouse." Then she began to laugh.
The animals in the mitten looked at each other. First they smiled. Then they began to giggle and laugh. They laughed so hard.